episode.
Brown Sugar Babe.
The podcast. Like the we just come in so random.
We really do.
We just have our key things that we say. Do. Another but episode.
But I really look forward to when I'm listening to it. I look forward to the randomness or the chitter chatter before.
What we talking about before. What we talking about. Sometimes we singing. Sometimes we just, you know.
Because speaking of singing.
What's up?
How Beyonce just blessed my Netflix.
Girl,
we haven't talked about that, huh?
I have not.
We're going to
because we skipped it. We'll talk about that in this one. But
I was sitting here on my phone. That's definitely one as well.
Oh,
we're sorry, babes. We skipped last week, so we couldn't really. We didn't talk about nothing, but we're back.
Hey, y'all.
We be going through life, y'all, which is why the
episode.
This episode is crucial because we're going through it. Mm-hmm. And so we want to give tips. And also, y'all give us tips on how to keep it organized.
We're not perfect.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
We're trying to figure it out like everybody else.
Adulting.
Jesus. 101. Okay, adulting. Girl.
Yes. Honest. Yes. Ooh. But we'll get into that.
How y'all feeling?
Yeah, later. How you feeling, love?
I'm feeling aligned. Excuse me. Okay. Y'all, I'm eating gummy bears here.
I know. They look so good, but I ain't even playing around with my teeth.
Mm-mm. Look. I'm telling you, I had to eat on one side.
I know
some of y'all can relate.
But you know, I got my issue right here, so I ain't even trying to drill it down on this.
But I'm feeling aligned. I was just talking to the girls earlier about what I had read about my day today based on my horoscope. I know some people don't believe in that, but whatever. And I just felt like my day was just like very aligned with how I was feeling and what I was doing for myself. It just all felt really good and very fluent. So I'm feeling aligned within myself and what my week gonna be like and just, you know, just life.
Yeah.
You know. Right now.
But you're here.
Mm-hmm. You know, right now. Blessed. Tomorrow, we never know.
Right. Life is like a box of chocolate.
Right now, I'm feeling.
Right now.
Ask me this in an hour.
Okay.
It'd be different.
Okay. And that, we're going to talk about that. Because right now, we're going to talk about that.
We're going to unload our baggage.
What about you guys? What's going on?
Chloe.
How do you feel?
I got a lot to say, so I'm gonna go last.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm feeling blah. This is the only feeling emotion blah. I could get. Yeah, blah.
At least you look the opposite.
Right. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, everything's good. Just, you know, adulting. Yeah. I feel like I've been saying that word all week. Like, people ask me, like, what's going on? Adulting.
We have a name for it.
Adulting.
And that's what
just
it is.
Just getting it together.
Just, you know, I feel like I'm ready for April to be over. I know that because it has been an up and down emotional roller coaster. Mm.
Them highs and lows or something.
Mm. Girl. And I think it's April. I don't know what's going on up there in the universe. I don't know with the earth and the moon and star. I don't know. But I just know I'm done with April.
And I can May tell you what's happening.
Can bring his ass on.
I can tell you
what's happening.
The game is testing us.
We got to stay 10 toes down.
I'm telling you.
No.
That's a segue into how I'm feeling. I'm feeling tested.
Come on.
I'm feeling tested. Okay, because it's when I say every area of my life right now is giving me a struggle.
Mm.
And what I'm learning to do is appreciate that because I know the only reason why the enemy is getting to me is because I'm about to break through
something. About to happen.
So instead of me being distracted by my problems, I'm focusing on where I'm trying to go.
That's right.
And that's hard because I was breaking down crying on Friday. Friday, I was losing my mind. Mm. But again, I'm like, you know, it's just a test.
I had this test before.
Yeah. I had this test. And then because another thing that helped got me out of my, like, I was rolling into a dark place.
Mm-hmm.
What really got me out of there is all the praise reports that I was receiving from my friends.
That's right.
I have a real solid group of people in my life, including y'all. And y'all inspire me and y'all keep me going. And I really look up to each and every one of the people that I have in my circle. Because I'm like, I really just, sometimes I reflect on who I have in my space because you know that's important,
right?
And I'm just like, dang, I really got some solid people. Like, I can go to anyone and be and kind of talk to them, and it's like they respect how I'm feeling even if they don't agree with it. Not saying that they do, but if they don't agree what I'm saying, they still respect that it's my process and it's my journey.
Amen.
So I just appreciate everybody, including y'all, everybody that I have, and I know y'all listening because y'all tell me y'all listen to me. So I appreciate all my friends. Thank y'all. Because one, let me just break down some praise reports for y'all because I have to because...
That's right.
Speak up.
I've had a really hard week. Like, my week has been so hard and I'm like, the game gonna test you.
Mm.
But I dare not fold.
That's right.
Come I dare on. Not.
Better not.
That's such a great episode last week. If you not. Haven't heard it and you're listening, I highly advise that you go back.
Go listen to the episode.
And then come back. And then okay. Come back. So let's just start with a little bit. Jada, she got a new job opportunity.
That's right, Jada.
Jada, I love you. Jada been working really hard for a long time, and I've been watching her, and I'm like, it's okay, it's coming. And I've been keep telling her, I'm like, I know you don't want to hear this, but it's coming. And it finally came. And I'm like, look how he showed out, girl. I'm not gonna tell her personal business, but he showed out.
Congrats, Jada.
So boom, that's one friend.
Yeah.
My guy friend, the one that y'all give me a hard time about.
Oh my.
He got a promotion type thing in his job, and he just got there like right after his 90 days. They're like, he hungry, he working hard. Boom, number two.
Congratulations, girlfriend. We love you despite what scenario.
Exactly. We don't have any problems with you, disclaimer.
I'm just kidding. He knows I was in good fun. Sabrina's pregnant.
Yes.
Sabrina.
Congratulations, babe. So happy for her.
Right.
So happy for her. Y'all, she's such a great mom.
Like, oh my gosh. Raven just got this huge thing with her cooking.
Raven a cook?
She cooks.
Raven. Oh, wow. We knew what's that.
I don't know.
Wait
a minute.
Yes. Her, Mississippi's getting a podcast up and going. He got the visuals. He's like on his way. I'm like, everybody, like, all this good news. I wouldn't dare just be, it would be selfish if I'm just, man, I'm messed up because I got something going on with me.
Right.
And I can't celebrate my friends.
And so look, I'm like, it's trickling to everyone, so that means it's coming to
that's
you.
That's what I believe, like, because everything attached to me wins. So I know sometimes the devil will put it in my face and, like, you know, you're not doing well, but look at everybody else is doing well. Now look at you, you're not shit.
Mm.
And that's how I was a little bit on Friday, but I'm like, no, I'm going to focus on glass half full, not glass half empty, because happiness is a choice.
Yeah.
So instead of me choosing to be sad, because I have a lot of reasons to be sad right now, I'm just going to be happy that at least other people that I care about are winning.
Right.
So I really appreciate that. So I feel tested, but we're going to keep moving.
Well, you don't look like what you're going through.
I appreciate that, because
you look good.
Right.
In your yellow, in your mustard.
And like I was telling her, you know how y'all look on melanin, honey.
Yeah.
Looking beautiful and vibrant.
With
her little puffs.
Yeah.
Her husband called it a fine apple earlier. That's right. That's right, you little fine apple.
Yes. More of those type of men in America today.
Fine apple.
That's what we need.
That takes me out.
That is right. Beautiful.
I love to see black love.
Oh, I do too. You.
I love to see love, but I especially love to see black love.
It's hard. I'm not going to lie. It's hard. But I mean, when you really think about it at the end of the day, it's like, okay, I'm a choose. Everything is a choice.
I choose you.
I choose. Like, you wake up every day, you could be like, I'm good.
Yeah.
And because I know I have a lot of reasons for somebody to say I'm good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But he'd be like, okay, we got this.
Yeah, I do.
And I'd be like, you get on my nerves, but I love
they
you.
They do.
And I don't want to be with nobody else because I can't deal with nobody else shit.
But yours, I said I do to your shit.
I didn't say I do just to say I don't.
Come on. That's
word to Tiana, okay?
Yeah.
Don't give me no reason. Anyways. Okay.
That's beautiful.
Look at this one.
Oh. I love you.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Damn studio. I cannot.
Bish what? Oh, let me add before we get into the actual topics that I did go to the Millennium Tour last week and
I saw you. I hope your chicken head through the entire night.
Girl, okay. I miss Chingy. I was so mad. But he came at the end of somebody's set, and I got to do it a little bit.
Okay, good.
But I had a ball. Shout out to the
y'all
twins, Kyra and Alicia.
Yeah,
for that. Speaking of Kyra and Alicia, shout out to a personal shout out from me because of what you told me in.
Yes.
Y'all,
they
love my heart.
Sonara.
And I'm trying to figure out what to do with that gift because a lot of people are telling me that. And I'm like, you know what?
Me and Lauren Ben told you need to be at Bible study on Wednesday.
I think I'm going to start something. He's doing great things in
my
life.
They really said they just love how you can, like, connect real life situations to, like, a word.
Yeah.
Like, they really feel like you're super anointed with that. And I was like, Sonara be having us rolling. She be so serious.
But I be serious. But I mean,
know.
It's like.
It's great.
It just comes out that way.
Exactly. Hey. He uses you as a vessel.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
I receive all that. Thank you, God.
Yes. But no, the Millennium Tour was great. And I know people are still going in different cities, so I ain't going to spill the beans. But it was a phenomenal tour.
But what's up with Raspy, though?
He just seemed like he owns glasses. Some. I don't know. Like,
get off the drugs.
Yeah, that could be a little
Instagram
bit of
Instagram live about some glasses?
What do you mean? What happened?
Somebody stole his glasses. Somebody invited to the hotel room to get his glasses.
And so he got on Instagram and was like,
y'all,
bitching and complaining. I know who you are. Give my glasses.
Hell no.
I want my glasses.
You know what's funny? I had a homeboy's boss come down here to Houston to visit, right?
Mm.
And so he was, you know, we were communicating back and forth because he wants to know, you know, what to do, blah, blah, blah. So her last night here, he said that she told him some dude got robbed in the hotel, and he was like screaming up and down the hallway of the hotel. And was like, I got robbed.
He's so eccentric. I think that's just his part. He's just eccentric.
I got robbed.
He's just very eccentric.
Don't you want to keep it to yourself? That's kind of embarrassing.
I know.
Especially when it's those type of situations. Yeah. Like, you basically let the vagina get you robbed.
No, for real.
Oh, literally.
That's a lesson for you.
Foolish.
Now that's a word.
I know.
Settle down.
Poor baby. But they all did good at the concert. It's a really good concert. Probably one of the best ones I've ever been to, low key.
Damn, that's a big statement.
It's nostalgia. The whole concert is just nostalgia. So
I ain't gonna lie, when I was watching some of the Instagram stories, I was literally singing along.
Yeah,
they did this. Right. And the vlogs, of course.
And to see everybody walk into the stadiums with their spray paint shirts and jersey
dresses,
Air Force Ones, hilarious.
Just like you got in the time machine.
A lot of different outfits.
Like, it's so cute.
It was so much fun.
It was cute.
But
that
is
beautiful. Okay, well, speaking of concerts, let's move on right on over to Beyonce.
Oh,
Queen.
The queen.
Relax. My knees are hurting from the choreography.
Oh my God. Girl. Homecoming. And you know what?
I'll be hosting practice.
I just got my edges back. Okay.
Girl, I remember watching that concert last year live and when I was in Thailand.
Like it
was up the street. You know, when I was in Thailand last year. Not when I was at the house. I was in Oklahoma. I was in Louisiana.
I was about to say New Orleans.
Streaming it from Thailand. Ooh, I was super early in the morning, I remember. But I'm so happy that she blessed us to stream this on Netflix. Because I remember watching it, and I remember just saying, white people don't deserve this.
this whole HBCU black pride.
Like, y'all don't even know what y'all are experiencing right now.
I bet she brought the HBCU.
They know now.
Oh, my God. You know now. And I'm just so happy to be able to relive that again. Because it's so good. It's so damn good.
That what?
That clicked something else, another bitch I had for it. Speaking of HBCUs, but we'll get back to that.
Okay.
We're going to come back to that.
Put a pen.
But, I mean, it's funny for me, and it was kind of like a heartfelt moment for me because I was telling, my husband and his sister, I was like, you know, back in the day, you know how they asked you when was the first time you seen you on TV? For me, it was Destiny's Child. Like, when I seen Destiny's Child, bills, I was like, look at me on TV.
Right.
Like, I'm like, no, black women, here we are.
No, and they were young. You was like, wait a minute. Like, that's me.
And then Bugaboo,
TV.
Girl. Yeah.
And especially.
With a marching band, come on.
Bills in the salon. You was like, bitch, I go to the salon.
At first we thought, we're cool. Yeah. You see the rollers in their head.
You know what I'm saying? Us being from Houston, you'd be like, what is it? What salon is that?
Right.
I know it's in Houston.
That just gave me, like, it gave me flutters because for my daughters to see it. Because Raleigh was like, who's Beyonce? And I was like,
wait,
you gonna
have
learn.
A seat. And we've been Papa watching Squad. Beyonce ever since.
Girl.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, I like her. Now she's trying to do the dances and stuff.
I've seen Homecoming probably 3 times already. Yeah. It's just so, I feel like.
It's good.
Just out of concerts. Good. There's never a concert that I've been to that I feel like, you know, I can go back and still be like, but with this particular concert, I can watch that back to back to back and still get like hair on my arm just raises because it's so good.
Then she dropped the album.
And that's the thing. God, the same feeling comes when I listen to the album. I listen to it and I'm just like, oh.
Yeah.
It just makes you feel so sexy. Like, as a woman. It just makes you,
and then so
as a black person.
Black
you know?
To the way she
so
mixed.
You know?
She can stuff melanin down your throat.
Girl.
Ooh. the Negro National Anthem, okay? My hair matching my bag.
And I ain't gonna lie, she literally made me wanna go to homecoming.
Yeah.
I was like, okay. Yeah. Like, she got me excited as shit to go.
Who homecoming? I'm about to go.
No, seriously. Girl. Watching this made me, like, I love my college. I love the school that I went to. I went to a PWI, predominantly white institution. But watching that made me just regret, like, God damn, I should have went to.
It ain't nothing like
that swag,
it.
Sir. Ain't nothing like it. That swag, sir.
When everybody know what they doing?
In a park, nigga. Yes. In a party. Or even at a game.
Mm-hmm.
Girl, to see a whole crowd doing that—that is amazing.
That should have caused an earthquake in Coachella, but it wasn't enough black people to understand. The concept thing
was, everyone on that damn stage was having a ball, girl. And I think that's what I loved about it too.
The story behind it, the fact that she handpicked everybody that was on that stage for a reason
for 8 months for 2 hours, y'all. Girl,
that shit was amazing to me. It, like, the documentary or the film, right, in itself was more to me than just the music. The music was amazing, but it's just Beyonce as a person. Show.
I feel like this is the first time we actually got to see Beyonce, really the most humanized I've probably ever seen her. Yes. Just to talk about her pregnancy, the weight gain, everything that she had to do to get back
and
to herself.
To see her
do it, right?
Like,
how
you
she
like
was,
bitch,
the big old mom
was,
boobs.
Yeah.
You was thick, right?
Beautiful. You carried them
still
twins.
Beautiful, but you
carried them twins.
I think she did that to make sure people knew. Yeah.
Because y'all got me messed up. I feel like everybody, Beyonce, y'all got me.
I am
the hardest working woman.
She really is.
On this planet.
She really is.
And y'all gonna know. Because
you see, she said it a couple times. She's like, thank you, Coachella, for making me the first black woman to headline. Yeah. Ain't that a bitch?
Ain't that a bitch?
Ooh! I was like, you better throw
and
that
And I'm going to make sure that it's the best show of
ever.
All time.
That was how Michael
that's
Jackson.
What's so inspiring. Because it's like, Beyonce is Beyonce. Beyonce has reached really phenomenal heights. Mm-hmm. So for her to push herself even more, like, she sets these expectations for herself.
Every time.
And it's nobody but her.
It's like, God. For some people, it's like, I would never ain't gonna do that shit. I got this many awards. I got this, I got that. I can just And she's like, no, I'm going to set another bar.
Yeah.
And I'm going to do it again and again and again. And that's what makes her so fucking lovable. And it inspires you.
She could have easily gave us the same songs like she did, but played them just the same. Mm-hmm. She could have got on stage and did the,
like she said, with her little song,
with her flower, and sung us the same song, did the same. Mm-hmm. But the way that she remixed every single one of
the
same
other people's songs.
The album, I haven't stopped listening to the live album. It's just so lit. It's just so lit. It's just so lit. And we thank you.
We thank you.
Because I felt the same way with the Beyonce experience. I don't know if everybody got that, but she put that out in high school. It was kind of like the same song. She had a lot of horns. Like, because I've been a fan. Okay?
Yeah, of course.
So me and, like, when we were on the bus, I remember, like, it was yesterday, on the way to cosmetology school. This our junior year in high school.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Sabrina, like, going hard to, like, we know Beyonce experience from front to back.
Yeah.
All the harmonies, because, you know, she never sing the song like she's singing on an album.
Yeah, never.
So the live version, like, we know all of that. Yeah. And then for her to come out with some of those same songs
and remix differently.
And make it a halftime show.
Girl.
All I'm going to say is, get y'all horn game.
What's
up,
crazy is, and I'm trying not to get too excited. So the Battle of the Bands is here in Houston this year.
Oh, bitch.
And with all this HBCU homecoming, I'm just praying that
can you please come?
Can you bless us with your presence and have your band come? But it's just perfect. It is just perfect.
It is perfect.
For Labor Day. So not only do we get the Labor Day classic with PV&TSU the day before, then the next day is the Battle of the Bands here.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, you have no choice, B. Yeah.
We got to be there.
Public service announcement.
And I feel like she also, how do I say it? Like, for the black people who didn't know about HBCUs, because before I went to college, I didn't know about HBCUs. I didn't.
Okay.
I went to a HBCU, but before being in high school, I didn't know anything about them. So I feel like she like brought back the excitement, or
because people don't go to games.
She shed
stuff
the light
like
exactly on the culture that is HBCU. So for people who, even other people who have known it or went to one, didn't have as much pride or wasn't supporting, I feel like she brought all that back. And it's just like, now moving forward, I feel like more people, like black elitists or black excellence, they're gonna start giving more money and start supporting more of the black schools.
Yeah. People are gonna
institutions,
want to go.
And it's just gonna be like a snowball effect.
Yeah.
So even for that's even more inspiring.
and bitch. Yeah. That's why exactly. She's a queen.
Yeah. Like, seriously. Oh my
it God. Did. I'm not gonna lie. It did fill me with a little resentment because I did leave. I went to Prairie View and I left, and I was like, damn, I should have finished.
It's okay. It's
just, I mean, Beyonce gave us what we was missing. Can you, do you understand that though? She didn't get to. She said Destiny Child was her college.
Was she her college. Did. Right. Life was
okay,
her college.
I'm so sorry that you got the short end of the stick. You know, I'm so sorry Destiny Child replaced your college.
Girl, but
when she brought them out, do you hear me?
I said,
go ahead, Michelle. I was like, you better be keeping up. Cause, honey.
She's so cute with her little
And then Kelly, I was like, Kelly, you better
come on.
Me.
Yeah.
You better. Because Kelly will give you that. She give you that effortless. Them
that
effortless
yeah.
moves. Like, baby. Ooh, honey.
It was just a great show.
It was amazing. Was great show. But for her to give you a whole, she made herself into a university mm-hmm. so people could attend her.
Mm-hmm.
It was Beyonce. Like, mm-hmm. that was the university.
I'm still trying to get this
that was her band. That was her band. That was her line, her fraternity,
exactly.
her dancers, her major. That was Beyonce. So, like, it was a university, and you got to attend her.
Shoot. I've been to a couple of HBCU homecomings, and that by far was the best one I've ever seen, personally.
So, Beyonce University, here we
go. Wow. It was so live. It was
Shout
so live.
Shout out to all the people in college right now.
It's your live.
Y'all, and all the people in band right now.
Mm-hmm. I know. Y'all probably lit. Samples, probably lit. Drum lines. So lit. Yeah. Now they can play them songs.
Right. Yeah. And it's easy because the music is already made. Yeah. Like, you got to put it in, you know.
Yeah. It's already there. It's already banned. It's already.
Like, we got to go to Battle Bands this year. We have to.
I can't wait. Yeah. Because I missed that. I'm like,
y'all, let's try
to
do like a live. Y'all think we could do a live?
Ain't no way.
We
it's gonna be too loud.
Right. It's gonna be too loud.
It's gonna be too loud and live.
Right. And I ain't even gonna wanna be talking. Yeah. I don't even wanna see the show.
Okay, I don't know. I'm there for the football game.
Like the commentary. Let's see if we can get in the box.
Yeah. Don't play.
Can we get in the box?
Bring it on. Grambling State University.
Here we
the
go.
Ladies of Brown Sugar Babe, the podcast.
Who gave them the mic? Who gave them the mic?
Hey,
you know how they be like, from the West.
Yeah.
The boldest. The boldest. Here they come.
Often imitated, but never duplicated.
Yo, where did we
the
sign
Rancho
up?
The Rancho Carne Toro.
Not that she went to a whole cheerleader
school. Hey, I love football, yo.
You got me too.
That's
seriously
experience.
The only reason why I miss high school so much. Like, Rally being a highlight and being the football. Oh, yeah.
That
so
was,
much fun.
That was really
so
fun.
Much fun. And Shout when we started out. To get Damn a little my. Bit more blacker, you know, it made me appreciate Beyonce's things because it's like I low-key had a little bit of that experience.
A little bit.
A little tad.
To me, because in high school, well, our high school, because we all went to school, you know how the drum majors were when we were there?
Yeah.
They are not like that no more. They get down like you was at Witherie.
Yeah. They got like that our senior year. They started to get a little bit more
seasoning. Because they performed at the rodeo.
And they color. Yeah, they be lit.
They performed at the rodeo
how
one day when
Imani
was there. they were cute. But it wasn't that many of them. It was there for
y'all should have
I didn't see any of them.
They were cute.
They were cute.
She did this little eye roll like,
I mean.
I was trying to remember. It was just the band and the drum majors. But the drum majors was, they was like,
they were
okay.
Okay.
I was like, okay.
Look, I was just telling Chloe the other day. I said we was looking at the draft. I say, what is in the water? Because these babies,
these are homegrown men.
These babies, these are some men.
This is country.
This is
cornbread.
Where you?
What? Imani school goes to middle
sport?
School, and them boys are big. You can't tell me this not a grown
it's
man.
It's the chicken.
It gotta
That's
be the
what
chicken.
I'm All these kids, you know, our age,
baby,
people are now teachers. And, you know, when we were younger, of course, they were teachers when they were our age, too.
Yeah.
But it's just like when I can never imagine being a teacher because they're so big. They're so grown. And I would be a student. They would think I was a student. And they would try to try me.
Back up.
They still gonna try to
y'all,
ID me.
But it's so funny. My homegirl I went to college with is a teacher, y'all. And it's funny. It really is funny. Like, imagine yourself as a teacher.
Girl, I can't.
Yeah. Yo, I it's can. Exactly.
Sit y'all ass.
Hilarious. And she be like, if you don't, she, so she be on live sometimes, teachers.
Recording.
They had their field day. I don't know if it's field day season, but they had like some type
of
field
day.
Yeah,
it is. It's the end of the year. Oh my God.
She was like, it is the end of the year. She was like, back up. You are too close. If you don't sit back, just
you got to
just get back. I die.
You have to talk to them like that. Because that's how they talk.
You do.
And that's exactly how I would have, like, I could see myself talking to a student. Yeah. Like, if I was, like, teaching.
Yeah, are you I'm done? Like, oh, you need, are you look, done? You going to let me teach?
You need about five paces. Yeah. Take five steps, and that's what you need
they,
to do.
Girl, I have so many friends my that are teachers. My personal Yeah, and principals. And they be, them kids be charging these teachers up. And they have to, I'm the not teachers the one. Have to get right. They yeah. be, try me.
We've seen the not videos the of the teachers me. Going. Yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't get that far. I have to walk out. I'm like,
I'm gonna walk out before I'm gonna use the church
finger. Because sometimes I feel like these kids, they be texting.
Because I don't want to whoop you and your mama. You.
Right.
Let me just exit.
Now, and speaking of that, you and your mama, and speaking of schools, look at that alignment. We're gonna go right into another bitch. What? The Madison.
Yes.
Madison,
so,
y'all.
This was, yeah, this story kind of got viral. And I remember when I was at work when it came out.
Yeah, because so that's the first place I've seen in Channel 11. Shout out to you.
Shout out.
Because I was like, ooh, look at Chloe. Because I only look at Channel 11. I ain't gonna lie.
Come on, Chloe. You better give Chloe the rating.
Okay. I only
look at Chloe. Houston and you watch the news, you better only be watching Channel 11.
I see Channel 13. Channel 11. Where's 11?
We keep it fun and fresh for y'all.
Okay, you better put it out there. What's up, Jennifer?
But, right. But, yeah, so I'll say a Houston high school because if I say Madison, y'all wouldn't know what I was talking about unless you're in Houston. So a Houston high school principal basically created a rule for parents, a dress code for parents that basically says parents are not allowed to walk in the high school with pajamas, a robe, a bonnet, a shower cap, slippers, just anything.
But listen to these things that you're listing.
Shorts,
like,
two
what are you doing out here?
You know, it's so
it's targeting African American.
You know what? So I'm not gonna lie. I didn't write the story. I wasn't at work when it broke. But when I watched the story, and you know the way that it was portrayed, it's definitely pinpointing a certain class in race. Not even gonna lie, it definitely.
I mean,
is.
Because where the school is, I mean,
and if you and if you're in Houston,
background, if
right,
you're not from Houston, Madison High School
is a predominantly black
and Hispanic.
Black
yeah.
and Hispanic.
Yeah.
So it doesn't like surprise that. Me mm-hmm. that you'll see a mama or two come in with her bonnet and her robe and stuff. But as a you know, I'm with the principal. I'm not mad at the principal for making this rule. I'm not. Because I feel like if you are coming, I don't know. The bonnet, I don't
what,
know.
I wanted to ask, Sonar, what do you think as a mother? Like, if your kid was in high school and this was a high school your child went to and she made this rule, how would you feel? Because you know,
I would not go to my child's school like that.
Let me give you an example, though. So there's a lot of people on social media that was saying, like, sometimes it's an emergency. The school called you and said, come pick up your child. You at home, robe, bonnet, slippers, and all you hear is emergency. You need to come get your child. So mothers say they don't think about getting presentable. I'm just thinking about going to get my child.
I'm not thinking about being presentable, but I'm not thinking I'm about to walk out the house with a robe on. Yeah. I'm not about to walk out. I mean, if I walk out the house, I do walk out the house with my scarf on because I'm natural, my edges, but it go right in that glove compartment. Mm-hmm. When I get to my destination, it ain't nothing to take it off.
Yeah. But here's my thing.
I just like to be, I'm different. I gotta be presentable. I go out in some things.
Yeah.
But
I've been to Walmart in some pajamas. So
but they don't look like pajamas. They like joggers or sweatpants.
Here's my thing. So what if you wanted to go out with your scarf on? Let me tell you something. You are a principal of a school. Now, you can set rules and limitations for your students.
Yeah.
Mind you, that's a free school, too. This is not a private school. We don't have to pay. And this is a government-owned school. So you can have rules on the students, but you cannot tell me as an adult what to do and how I look when I come get my kid or put my kid in school for their education. So now you're putting another barrier for me, not for my kid not to have education. That's the last thing to be fucking worried about. Now, I understand, but you cannot tell. I just feel like with
that's
all
true.
The things
I mean,
that's going
true.
On, how you gonna tell a law-abiding citizen, I pay taxes, that I can't wear pajamas if I want to come pick up my kids? I'm not saying that I would ever do that. That's just not me. Like you said, Sonar, that's not this is not me. But
not me,
I don't
but.
Like I don't appreciate people trying to tell people what to do. Like you could tell your student, because that's a student in the school. You can tell them no pajamas, but you cannot tell a parent that you don't.
I mean,
have
I feel
no
like it's the same thing about a dress code coming to work. Like, you're not gonna go to work that way.
But that's work. That's somebody who pay you. You don't do shit for me. You do stuff for my kid, but you don't do anything for me. You don't pay my bills. You don't do anything for me. So how you gonna tell me what to do?
I'm on both sides of the fence.
I get it. I mean, I get it. As far as you know, I have a right to do what the fuck I want to do. I'm a grown up.
But my thing comes in. If I understand the principle, when her thing was, I'm trying to set an example for these kids.
Yeah.
So if you're coming in, and because if I'm not mistaken, a picture has been shared of like the mother that I think that she was talking about.
They got a police on her, from what I hear.
Yeah, she came in.
That's ridiculous.
She came in with a pink, but I'm pretty sure.
I mean, you kind of have to do that because if it escalates.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it escalated. I'm pretty sure we don't know the backstory as to why the police were called, but I'm pretty sure that mom, when they told her like, "Ma'am, you need to come back," when you, I'm pretty sure she threw rightfully so.
What was the picture? Because was she naked?
If I'm not mistaken. And she came in with like a pink or red bonnet, and she had on a gown, like you know, a long shirt, but it was kind of like a pajama gown.
Yeah.
And some slides. My thing is, this is a high school. You walk into school like that. I don't know if you had on any, you know, a bra or panties or something, but these are horny ass little, you know, horny ass little kids.
I just feel like the integrity of the environment.
But we can't control everybody, y'all.
You can't.
Like, if you go to the DPS, if you go to the post office, if you go to the corner store, if that's the case, then we need to put up signs everywhere and tell people how to dress and what to wear and how to look and how to be presentable. I understand integrity. That's cool, but that's a decision that she would have to make for herself as a
but
woman.
But I get it in a school. In DPS or Walmart or something, that's whatever. Different. That's on you. But I feel like when you're coming to a school,
to work, a church, or
I get it.
Like that.
But I understand your point. I feel like I said, that's why I threw the whole emergency thing because people were throwing that out there, and I feel you. Like if it's an emergency or something, I'm not thinking about what I got on. I'm coming to school.
Right. I get it.
I go many a places with a damn bonnet on. Walmart especially, because I don't care about impressing anybody at no damn Walmart, especially if I'm running in and running out.
Yeah.
So it's just
I just know how kids are, and I don't want to set my kid up to have
But if you get called, and it's an emergency, and your kid has done something, and now you got to think about what to wear. Make sure you good. Make sure you this. Make sure you that. Even though you should be, it's just kind of like, I just feel like this, it's just extra shit that you just...
It is extra.
I feel like the rule...
Because I don't think that should have to be in place. I mean, you just know what you come to school
and
at.
And if you see them at the front, and you see they're not presentable, stop them like, hold up, let me bring your son to you.
Yeah, exactly.
The way you look... That's how it used to be when I was in school.
You can't tell people nothing these days.
But the crazy thing, I'm pretty sure your mama dressed like she was, wasn't getting out the damn car no way. True. Like, if I was dressed in that way, I would text my son...
Come outside.
I'm outside. I'm not presentable to walk in. The principal needs to see. We're gonna have to speak another day.
Tell him come out to the car too.
Right. Tell him y'all come out. I'm not walking into school.
Yeah.
So just the fact that the principal even has to tell an adult
that's
what
I don't like.
Is what I didn't
but
like.
What if somebody really thinks that's presentable, y'all? Is that not okay?
Them. Yeah. It's
Why
not.
Do we have to what am I teaching you?
It's not.
Just come in sweats and shit. But that's the thing. She never
pajamas
said,
is her uniform. I'm playing devil's advocate here, guys. What if pajamas is her uniform? That's just in life.
No.
How are we walking around judging people and what they got on?
Throw on some tights and a shirt. Like,
I mean, there is a standard of what's presentable.
Yeah,
what
I just feel
not.
Like what she's
as
asking for
like
is not a lie. She's not asking for a lie. She's not asking you to come in a three-piece suit or a business suit or slack. She's not asking for that. She's just asking for you to not come to school
Take
with a bonnet and your pajamas on.
Try a head wrap or a turban. They can't tell you nothing about a turban.
Put your scarf cute.
And a bow. And maybe she would.
Put your scarf in a bow.
But then maybe she would say the turban was a bonnet, though. Who's to say she would?
I mean, you know what a turban is, and you know what a bonnet is.
Okay. This was a bonnet.
Next thing you know, she's going to be like, bonnet. All parents have to come in khakis and a white button down.
I think her letter was
I want to know what everybody else thinks. So we're going to have to post
a lot of people were with the, you know.
A lot of people were upset.
No.
The people I've heard are upset.
I heard a lot of people
because I feel like were you black people were upset or
because
I feel like maybe she was a
this is another
but it was a black principal
do.
I think it was I'm pretty sure I don't know I don't
and
let me lie
too.
But
I'm just thinking as far as the side of town because you know my my home church is right there so I've my whole life I've gone by Madison I've been in that environment and it's like you know that's what they expect from that type of school. So I guess they're just trying to change the
And I'm not mad at her for that. Like, I'm not mad at the principal for wanting, like,
they be looking
I'm
soulful.
Trying to make your students better and I need y'all help. I feel like that's where it was coming from.
I think
like,
that's
help
exactly
me
what
help
it is.
Your kids, bro.
But let me
How are we gonna get the kids to perform at a higher standard
right,
if you
I can't
don't.
Tell your kids to stop coming here sagging and all types of shit if you coming up here with pajamas. Like, I
but
can't.
Guess what? They go right back to that same home, and so
sure, do what you do
parent,
in your home
exactly. But unless the parent has changed, the kid okay. I just
I feel like you can't
control parents. You can have parent. How about you just have parent events at your high school and show them how to be presentable, as opposed to telling them what they can and what they cannot do? How about you present an optional?
I feel like that's worse than sending a letter just saying, "Hey, just don't come up there with a shower cap." Now we gonna have a whole ceremony about.
I felt the same ceremony.
That's worse. Like
I felt the same way when they made us wear clear backpacks that year in middle school. It was middle school. They was like, we had to wear clear backpacks.
Because people were bringing guns to school.
Nah, I went to McCullough and like.
Oh, that's because y'all was bad.
Yeah, people were bringing guns to school. That's why
y'all was blowing up lockers.
They probably bringing knives.
What you say?
They was bringing guns.
They probably brought knives.
Drugs. Like, I get it.
They bringing knives and drugs.
I get it. But not my thing is that it's just a like, handlebars. If this was something that you and your kid was going to like by yourselves, but do you boo-boo.
Yeah.
But this is something that, you know, it's culture. So I I understand both sides of the fence. I'm not on either side. Like, but you know, I don't care, because I agree with Lauren. You a grown ass person. You can't tell me what
I respect everyone's journey.
Right.
And all I'm saying is,
as long as the amount of energy that you put in about this dress code for parents, I hope you put the same amount of energy in the classroom.
I hope so. Okay. Absolutely.
That's all I have to say.
I hope them boys, they not sagging. I hope the pants are up.
Okay.
I hope
shirts are tucked in, belts are in the loops, zip tags applied if needed.
Come on. Come on.
And that's all I can ask for. I mean, because when you think about your children, I know y'all don't have kids yet, but I think about my kids and I'm just like, they're so precious. We must protect them at all.
And then public schools are no joke.
They're not. Kids are mean. And I would never, like, because I've heard kids make a comment about me to my daughter. Not to me. It was a good comment. They're like, that's your mom? She looks like a teenager. Like that.
Come on, you.
Right. Don't crack.
But you know, they got older moms. Their moms are older, and I just be like,
look, okay.
Hey, sis.
You better snap. Hey,
but,
sis.
You know, because we're singing the songs that they know. And they're like, what song is that? I'm like, oh, girl, yeah, that's Drake.
Yeah.
Like, but they make comments. And they're really mean. They bully you based on your parents. And I don't think that's right.
Yeah.
So I never want to put my child in a position to have to defend me.
Yeah.
True. I'm like, tell me, and I will pass.
Yeah.
Like, no, I just don't want to put my kid in that. Because, you know, when we seen some stuff in school, I'm like, whose mom is that? I never want to be a whose mom is that.
Yeah.
In a bad way.
And I'm pretty sure with this principal, I'm pretty sure she's seen it one too many times, which is why she
in
did
that
what
area,
she did.
I'm sure.
She's just like, I am tired of y'all coming to school
looking
like this.
I know you ain't go to work today. Look at this.
Like I said, she wasn't asking for slacks or jeans. Just put on some gym, some sweats and a shirt. Just come
Walmart
on.
Walmart got the pajama section in Walmart is popping right now. So don't say it's cost. Because I bought some nice velvet looking joggers that in the pajama section. And they look like sweatpants.
This girl said, I know you didn't work today. You go to work today. Look at how you look.
Yeah.
It's true.
When I say Beyonce and this dress code took us, we need to go ahead and get to the meat and potatoes.
Right.
But no, pause.
Oh, yeah. Your
I had a thing.
This and the meat and potatoes. Come on.
That thing with the Howard thing, y'all, with the people walking their dogs on Howard campus. Y'all, did you hear about that?
I didn't hear.
I saw something, but I didn't get a chance
to
read
what happened?
It.
There's just people invading the campus. And
why?
Using it like a park, basically. And telling people, it was some white guy said, well, if you don't like it, then y'all can move.
Oh,
Howard. No, not even HBCU. Howard University has been there for
Howard
like,
is a private forever. School, isn't
and
it?
It's a private school.
Yeah.
So it's like, what? What are you saying? Like, even, this
let
is
me tell you about this gentrification.
Outside of that, this is a
on.
Private property. This is private property.
It's a private
you
school.
Can't use, you just come and just. Put your just come and walk your ass up on
this
somewhere
isn't Herman
and tell
Park.
Somebody else to go.
Or like, just pick up your dog shit if you gonna do that.
But
like.
not even that. Coming from somebody who went to HBCU, if I see a white person just walking their dog,
are you lost?
Exactly, because it's just imagine if you was in high school and somebody was just walking. Couldn't nobody just walk down the hallway when you was going to class? So why can't anybody just walk on the
secure.
Campus?
Y'all went to private schools. That's why. That was very popular.
Security
walking dogs up and down campus.
And I'm pretty sure the people that do it was probably popular wherever they went to college. Mm-hmm. But this is not a public
not your space.
School, so you can't do that.
You ain't going to HBU.
They said they be having picnics. Bitch.
So you're going to come in my college campus. So you can be in the picture. Girl, and have
right.
Like there aren't any other parks anywhere else.
In the state, city, county.
That's, yeah. That's, you got that's to come wild. To the college I had to read that ridiculous. Story. That's definitely wild.
Let me tell y'all.
And the fact that he even said y'all could go somewhere else.
Where?
Where we going to go?
You want us to move
you
to
You
going to
pick up my whole school and move it somewhere?
Where we going? All right.
Nigga, I got class in 5 minutes.
Hey, okay. Where are you class? Where am I going?
And you know what? When I said preview, they didn't even allow. You can have pets.
Really?
No.
And the kid, well, not on my campus, either. I mean,
people snuffed their pets. They definitely had a bad pets.
I never stayed in the dorm. Exactly. I always stayed off campus. Oh, no. So maybe that's why I'm so used to like.
In the dorms, you cannot have pets.
Yeah, you
and
could.
I'm pretty sure
hiding their pets in their
in their purses and stuff like that. Exactly. You could not.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's crazy. It's crazy. I ain't going to sit here and say there weren't people that probably were on the campus that didn't go to the school because they definitely were. But they were black. Yeah. I'm just saying. Like, yeah. If it wasn't, you know, of course you'd be like, you don't go here. But they look like they could.
Yeah.
And no and random if I white person just sitting on the promenade like, what up? Like,
and
what
even if you
fuck?
Were, as long as you was respecting the campus, I wouldn't give a shit. Like, come
not
embrace.
Not at HBCU.
Really? No, I would be like, come ma'am. Embrace the culture. Embrace. What you want to learn?
Okay.
Some white people really, mm-mm. because there's white people who went to PV. I know plenty of white
well,
people.
Well, no, no. Wait, there, no, there was a Chinese boy that went to Clark Atlanta. And that, if I remember right, there was a white boy that went to Clark Atlanta, too. Yeah, there was.
There is white
it wasn't like that. It was just like, I don't know. Like, you just walking your dog and your dog shitting and shit. And you just using it like it's just.
This is a dog park.
You know, this is a place where we uplift black. It's just a lot of. Black and it's just like you know like not aww. With your little leisure you just leave me we in here working here we here trying to get education
and you walking
that
up.
Y'all tried to hold back from us for all
oh,
these guys.
No. My ancestors
nah but no I
nah
I just,
but nah
I, no but, nah. But I feel you 100%
I wouldn't discriminate them if they wanted to come on campus just to walk around and see like,
no Chloe
I feel like
they're
you
not walking
through
around
the
I get what you're saying Lauren I'm just saying if ever if they didn't have a dog and if they
not
wanted
my
to HBCU. Come right let me stop talking about her HBCU continue
I get it though
like,
I'm
if
just
somebody
like,
just walked in here walked in your dorm and was like oh this look real historical what is this and you'd be like kid, who are you
who let you in here
I don't know why that wouldn't bother I feel like the
you
more we
Shelby?
Try to educate these white people the more they may stop hating us that's just me though
I feel like you need permission to come on campus I mean
if it's a private campus and maybe that's why I can't relate because I went to a public campus so yeah. People were in and out of the campus all the time.
Really?
Big ass school. It was a big ass school. And it's a public campus.
Yeah.
So, I mean, people came in and out all the time. Mm.
I know alums for your school and they're very proud of their school and
yeah,
they're like they're open and it's just
it's
like,
open. Like
whatever
come on,
goes,
what you want to learn?
Like,
I'll show take
see,
you here there.
Around here between Norman and
right.
Weston.
And that's what I say. Maybe I don't know how it is on it. I'm pretty sure if I went though, I understand like you this is
like a dear
this
white
my baby.
Moment. Yeah.
Then my shit.
Yeah. It is like a dare white people moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. I get it.
Oh my gosh. Jeez, y'all.
Jeez. Just pick up your poop and go have your picnic.
It's like, let us have something.
At
I get
dog
it.
Park.
Let us have something.
Because I don't really know too much about gentrification and all of that because I don't think I've ever really experienced it, but I hear about it a lot and I hear that it's just
you go
like
downtown
to
Third Ward and you see these nice houses.
Yeah,
built
gentrification.
Next to the,
you ever been to Turkey Leg Hood and you seen them nice townhomes around Turkey Leg Hood?
But I thought gentrification was like people trying to move you out.
In a sense,
they're buying
the old black property to move.
But how is that moving people out? If
they're
already
going,
abandoned.
No, not all of them are
no,
abandoned.
Not
they're
abandoned.
Like, hey, we want your house. Tell us.
So
your
in
number.
The Third Ward, they're asking elder black people who stay in Third Ward. They're mm-hmm. giving them like, hey, I'll give you $100,000
yeah,
to sell your home and move, so we can tear it down and build like this nice
want.
Duplex or something. That's gentrification,
and that's what they're doing. They're doing it.
They're doing it everywhere
hard.
In Houston. Yeah.
So
they're okay. doing it right there on West Bedford, coming towards towards. Post Oak, like yeah. Marlin area, it's a house.
Look at the mall.
Listen.
Look at Sienna.
It's
and
a house.
That's gentrification.
It's
the
a
mall.
House.
Okay,
West
Sienna
Belford.
Is not was not to me wasn't really okay.
It's a house.
Sienna
was it considered the mall? That's just
Missouri.
I'm just like that's not really
City.
Considered the mall.
You
oh, know. No,
that's Missouri City, not the mall.
I'm speaking of like
that's
the
why
whole...
I was like you heard me. I kind of hesitated. I was like, wait.
They slowly gonna
but
push
look,
their ass
a,
to
you
2234
know you
by
know
far means.
Yeah. That's the hood.
Yeah,
there's a house on West Belford right now, and I looked it up. $500,000.
But here's what I'm saying. Because I hear a lot as if it's like it impacts like the community a lot. Like, how does that impact negatively to the community? Does it bring the property value up?
We can't afford it.
Yes.
That's it in a nutshell.
Okay.
We as black people cannot afford what they're trying to do. So they're moving us out. So they can move these nice complexes, duplexes, houses in.
That we can't afford it. Back.
So we can't come back.
Well, they can't because I can't afford it.
Have y'all been to Siena lately?
Yeah.
I haven't been.
It's not the same.
It's not the same Siena.
I knew it wasn't going to be the same.
Until Run, them not the same.
Bro, them apartments in front of Siena?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. What's wrong with them?
Nothing, but they look to be nice.
I like what they did
now.
With the restaurants though.
Yeah, like what they're building up the different businesses and stuff like that. I think that's real. It's bomb. But I mean,
people
like, as
are
far
finding
as the
ways
neighborhoods,
in.
The neighborhoods are not as how they used to be. Like when we were in high school, like how
because they got these wannabe thugs living in these homes trying to sell drugs and stuff, and they come from billion-dollar families. That's why.
Really,
that's how Till Run became what it is. Like y'all parents, y'all live in 2-story houses. Okay. Nice houses.
2 and 3 stories.
What you selling drugs for? Yo, you got two parents with two jobs. What are you selling drugs for? What
you drive a whole car.
You drive a Benz.
Bus line don't even come out here.
What? Cut it out.
They just let the parking ride. They just built the parking ride for the toll road.
Like, y'all come from good families and y'all trying to be, you know, different. Like, you're trying to.
You want
it
better.
Stupid. Like, it's stupid.
You want better.
Anywho. We're getting very local.
It's the mindset. Yeah, we are being very local. Take it to a town hall meeting.
We going to the next city.
Right. Right. Let's go.
You got it.
We got something to say.
Okay. Give me the mic.
Let me just play this episode.
Okay.
Okay.
So, Beauty Corner, I wanted to talk about beauty and music.
Today. Nice.
Okay. Yes. So, y'all, if you follow me on social media, at her name is Lo, shameless plug, on Instagram.
Hey, follow her, y'all.
Well, I don't be posting shit.
Nothing. That's
okay. But I just be honest.
Okay. That's okay.
Off topic.
I do every day you post a little audio.
Yeah.
Or are you in the gym? Yeah, that inspires me with your dogs.
Thank you. You know, that's
when Cash put all the toilet paper.
She bad as hell. And then, side note, now King does shit to get her in trouble. So we think it's her all the time, and sometimes it don't be her.
You be jealous.
It's so sad.
Every time I go over there,
it's crazy. But y'all, so lately I've been listening to this artist named Lizzo. Y'all.
Okay.
Lizzo, just some background on her. Okay, her name is Melissa Vivian Jefferson.
Okay.
She was born in Detroit, but she moved to Houston, Texas when she was 10. She's 30 years old. She founded about 5 different hip hop groups. When she was living in Houston, she lived in a SWAT, and she started a group called Cornrow, y'all. She released her debut album in 2013 and just released a new album in 2019 called 'Cause I Love You. If you have not heard this album, you need to
go download her thing and listen.
She is the epitome of self-love, y'all. Like her music makes you feel like the most confident person ever. She really just exudes confidence. She doesn't allow anybody to dictate what her what confidence means to her or how she feels about herself. Mm-hmm. Her message is really just really pure, and it's just really just about self-love. Y'all need to go check her out. I've been jamming her for like the past couple days.
Oh, I did see you. I see you. You posted one of her songs on your story. I was like,
yes.
Who is this?
And then all her background dancers are plus size.
Because
she's a plus size girl.
Yeah.
Which makes it even more like bomb, because you rarely see, you know, I don't want to say that because there are plus size, but the stigma with, you know, plus size and all this, she just like breaks down all them walls. She's like, bitch, I'm set. What?
Duh.
This is, look.
Yeah.
even with that, it's just inspiring. She inspired me. Like, after reading her story and just her music,
beautiful.
She just inspires me. And
I
she's
can't
so
wait to
talented.
Listen. I love new albums. Thank you. Thank you for that.
So,
love
new music. Girl.
Thank you. All right, Sanaa, get our mind right real quick.
I just have just a little bit because church was so good today, y'all.
Come on, word of restoration.
Ooh, church was so good. Like, you can ask Derek. I was really in there dancing. Like, it was an amazing service. It really fed me. I just want to talk about one thing, and it's just about being steadfast.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay? That means to not move. Like,
Ain't that how that song go? Be steadfast.
Come on.
Immovable.
Oh.
Okay.
Always. Okay.
I don't know, but I like that.
I like that one too.
It's such an old church song. I'm sorry. Keep going.
No, I know that. Press down, shake it. No, that ain't even steadfast. Shaking together. That ain't even that one. That ain't even that one. Never mind.
Go ahead.
He was just saying, you know, you have to be still sometimes. Like, we're moving. We don't give time. We don't give stuff time to settle.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, you
come with that line, Miss Sonara, for this week's episode. Come on.
You gotta, like, I took some notes. Well, actually, Derek took my notes this morning. Thank you.
Come on.
Come on, girl.
Supportive husband.
Come on.
Yeah, he told me I was typing too slow, but I was like,
oh, he said, I know. You missing.
You know, them men, message. They help you with that criticism on the side.
Yeah, I was trying to read her notes. She was typing too slow.
I'm sorry. He's reading the notes, though, so that's all that matters.
Come on. Right.
But it was just like, you have to be firm, and you have to stay in place and give things time to work, because you know, I know sometimes we're so goal oriented, it's like we're constantly moving, working, and we never stop and be like, okay, now let's see the effect to what we just caused.
Fruits of my labor.
Okay, so just this week we're gonna practice stability.
I'm really going to practice that.
We're gonna
week.
Stop
no lie,
because it's like the more stable you are, the more dependable you are. You notice somebody that's always moving you like, maybe I don't want to put that on you. I don't trust you with this yet.
Yeah.
But somebody's chill, they're centered, they like, okay, I'm ready to receive. He's like, okay, come on.
They seem like they have it together. Seem like they're
and
balanced.
You can actually help me, because you talk you to a stable person. It's just like, I done wasted fun.
Because I know that's me, because I'm always moving. You could be talking right to me. Like, I can be looking in your face, you talking to me, and I hear nothing you say.
Because
I'm making a list about doing this here. I'm thinking about what I got to do here.
Yeah.
I'm moving.
Yeah.
So that's one thing I need to practice. And I know he was saying in your job, in your marriage, in your career, sometimes you just have to be still and don't move. You have to have an unwavering faith that everything's gonna work out. So that's what I'm practicing.
Amen. I think I'm that's going it. To definitely practice
steadfastness.
No anxiety this
steadfast.
Week.
I'm just gonna be
like, it's handled.
You got to be steadfast. Well, let me give you that Hebrews 10 and 23, y'all. Like, that's the verse. And I just love it, because I posted it a long time ago. I posted it years ago. It actually just came back up on my time hop. And I'm just like, okay, Lord, I hear you working. I'm like, I hear you working in me. And I've been asking for signs and clarity. And I'm like, well, there it is right there.
Yeah. There you go.
And this is the summary of the service is, God is doing great things in my life.
That's right.
And I'm just going to hold on. I'm going to hold on to that. And I'm not moving. I'm not going to move in it.
Yeah.
You can't let your, like you said, the gang going to test you.
Stay 10 toes down.
Don't fold. Yep. And that's what I felt like he was saying to me in a biblical way.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to just leave you with this, and we can get into meat and potatoes, because I know we tripping.
We
tripping.
We had a good combo.
Hence needing to be organized.
Look.
Okay.
That means it's going to be,
organized and short.
Okay.
Short, but what it says, short, you know, because I love my God, I'm going to give you my scripture of the week. It's going to be Hebrews 10, verse 23. It says, let us hold fast to the confessions of our hope without wavering. Hold fast, being steadfast. Same thing. Without wavering, do not move.
Yeah.
For he who promised is faithful. So you have to have faith in your work and just let it be done. You got to move. You cannot move too much. You can't see your work being done.
Mm-hmm. And I think the biggest key word in that is having faith.
That is faith in yourself.
That's most of the time, that's the main reason why we just be moving. And
I feel like
everything.
Sometimes we don't take our hands off of something because we don't have faith in ourselves.
Exactly.
And I'm just like, give yourself more credit. You got
let it.
It
go.
Let it
be
go.
Confident.
Let it grow.
Exactly.
Let it go. All right, y'all.
Come on, let's get organized.
Okay, so this week's
like
episode,
three bullet points.
Right. This week's episode, we're going to be talking about getting organized and staying balanced, basically.
Yes.
We're going into the second quarter of the year.
Amen.
And I don't know out there for you babes who have, maybe you guys have taken on some new projects. Maybe you started a new business.
Yeah.
Maybe you're, you know, trying to get whatever things that you're trying to get done. It's important to be organized with them. It's important to be balanced with them. And we ourselves, the babes here, we are very busy. And we noticed
We noticed that, hey y'all,
we need, like we need, we noticed ourselves that we needed more balance and more organization within our own communication and with our own stuff with Brown Sugar Babe.
Yeah.
So this was just a very relatable episode.
Timely.
A very timely topic.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So I wanted to read something that I found online, and it says, when you are living with balance in your life, I basically Googled, like, how do you, what is balance? Basically.
Yeah, find your balance.
Exactly. It says, when you are living with balance in your life, you're living with peace and harmony every day. Balance comes in physical forms, emotional forms, and a spiritual form. Being in balance may mean something different to each individual. For me, having a balanced life means creating time for things I have to do, as well as things I like to do. Basically. Balance. So
yes.
I felt like that was so on point with us because mm-hmm. we're all different.
Yeah.
So when she said it's balance is different for everybody, I thought about us because Sonara's a mom with mom of two. She's in school. She just got a promotion at her job. Chloe has a very demanding job. She has mm-hmm. a very different schedule.
Yes.
You know, I have the very traditional schedule and I'm always doing something on the side. Like we're all moving.
Mm-hmm.
So we basically gonna get into it now with our little questions. So how do you guys balance? First of all, do y'all think y'all balanced in life? Like
not after that definition.
Girl.
But I love how they say like a balanced life is doing what you have to do and what you like to do.
Yeah.
And I'm really going to take that message mm-hmm. with being still this week mm-hmm. because I feel like lately I've always do what I have to do
mm-hmm.
but I forget to add in what I like to do.
Yeah.
And that will help with the peace.
Whew.
So that's bond, the harmony. So I really appreciate that definition. That was real. Mm-hmm. Now, but no, to answer your question, no, I am not mm-hmm. balanced mm-hmm. in the least bit.
I don't think I am either. I'm not balanced at all because I always feel like when I have one thing that I feel like is okay, I always feel like something else is lacking.
Yeah. Yep. I can never let myself off.
Mm-hmm. I can never get all of it like on the same level and all doing the same things and on the same frequency and feeling good. So
yeah.
I feel like I just have to work on how I view it.
Yeah.
Like like viewing balance as like a process versus a destination.
Right.
Like, I'm always be trying to like work towards balance.
Yeah.
Like it's not really something that I'm a get. Like mm-hmm. I feel like. And I feel like I read something.
If you get it, I feel like it's temporary.
I feel like it was an article in like Psychology Today. Yeah, I thought I was doing research about this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But this guy said that basically there are moments of feeling balanced.
Yeah.
It's never like a long-term type of thing. Like
right.
It's like okay. different moments and you want to strive to get those moments.
More often.
More yeah. often, but it's not something that's going to be a week or... And granted, you might get that
yeah.
those moments right after each other in a week, but it's always a process. That's basically the whole point. It's a process.
Yeah.
So I have to work on that because that would get my anxiety down
mm-hmm.
when something isn't balanced.
Yeah.
And I feel it going down, you know?
Yeah.
So that's what I have to work on.
That was me and my... For me, it's like I have to remember. Like,
yeah.
That's literally what I say, finding your center.
Yeah.
And when I say finding your center, for me... When I say that, that's my happy place or where I feel at peace.
Yeah.
So I'm like, when I'm about to go left, because it's so easy. And I'm like, how is it so easy for me to just be like,
yeah.
I'm mad.
It's like you don't even catch that moment before.
Yeah.
I'm like, what happened?
We're so used to going
there.
I don't
know.
Why is it so easy for us to be
it scares
mad
me.
And happy?
Mm-hmm. I'm unstable.
Girl, don't it make you feel like you need an on-call psychiatrist?
Like
you be like, wait a minute.
I'm still looking for
look.
Y'all, like, cause for me, I'm like, cause sometimes I'm saying in my head, it's something wrong with me.
Yeah.
I'm like, what is wrong with me?
Mm-hmm.
And I be like, I used to get mad cause Derek always, he would, it's not complain. He'd be like, yo mood, like,
yeah.
I don't understand.
I just got told that today, like, you in a mood today. I'm like, you know what? What you're not about to do is
okay.
read me.
It's read me. My book is not open.
Do you guys think that is related to being organized? And
yeah.
Being,
yeah.
Like, what
yeah,
that,
or, yeah, I can say, because he was right. I was in a mood, and I feel like that's because I was stressed about something mm-hmm. else.
It's always due to something.
Yeah, it's always due to something. And, mm-hmm. of course, like, he's just kind of getting the run of the stick.
Exactly.
And, yeah, that balance, that emotional
it's
balance.
It's hard, but I said, find your center, and I'm like, okay, let me just... Breathe real quick.
How do we get to that point?
It's hard.
Well,
what a research
I got some tips. I got a stat for y'all.
Okay. Okay.
Give me the
so
stats. I love
they
numbers.
Say that 15, this is from the National Soap and Detergent Association. That made me laugh. I don't know why that made me laugh.
But bitch, you better attribute. Come on.
Soap and detergent.
So 15 to 20% of the average American's household budget is spent on buying duplicates of items that were misplaced or lost as a result of disorganization. So that's just a stat about disorganization, and it can be, you know, applied to anything. Yeah. And it definitely says that being organized can assist you with reducing the feeling of being overwhelmed, achieving more in less time, gaining a sense of self-control, reducing the self stress levels, and having more time to spend on what you want to do, basically.
Right.
So
I've learned that.
Exactly. Yeah.
Seriously, like a organ. Like
y'all should see my planner.
Space,
I'm so proud of it.
Mine.
Bruh.
You see my plant is color coded and highlight.
And that's one like of the, that's moving. One of your things.
It
like,
is.
Ooh, having an organizer.
Comfort. Yeah.
I have like three you. Calendars. I have two calendars in my house. I have two. I have a work desk calendar, and I have my planner, and I have my phone.
So you write it down. You like, write I your
have
stuff
to
down.
No, if I have to see, I have to make a list. That's my thing. I am a queen of lists. Yeah. Anytime I feel like I'm getting overwhelmed, I'm like, oop, I need to make a list. I need to make a list because I got to organize my thoughts. Or I'm not going to get anything done.
Yeah, that's real.
And Derek, like I said, I always bring it back to my personal life. Like, he's like, you don't need this thing. You don't need a calendar. You don't need this. And I was like, okay. So I decided to let everything go out of whack. And I'm just like,
yeah.
Well,
yeah,
I mean, I had a calendar. I need a calendar. I need.
See,
stuff
you
to
need
write
it. He may
with.
Not need it.
Yeah.
So
now
now
he's learning what it is, like, and the purpose of it, and he's adjusting because now he writes things on the calendar. I'm like,
gotcha.
Yeah.
Write it on the calendar because I look at it every day.
Yeah.
So what are your things, Chloe, if you have any? Because you say you're not balanced, but I'm pretty sure you do something.
Well,
like,
no, I'm a mental organizer. Ooh, yeah. I'm like, I'm a day-to-day organizer. Because, you know, I always tell you guys, like, I'm not the whole goal thing, like setting stuff in advance. Like, I don't work like that. I'm a day-to-day type person. So I feel like I'm a, like an hour. Like, I know from this time to this time, I need to do this. From this time to this time, I need to do this.
You disciplined.
From this time to this time, I'm very disciplined. And so that's why I can be more mental, because I am disciplined. Like, I need to, I know what I need to get accomplished and when I need to get accomplished, especially when it's important. So, I'm definitely more mental. But I do understand the importance of writing stuff down, especially when stuff is in advance.
Yeah.
I pop up this calendar and be like, look.
What do I have?
Because I'm going to get it.
That's one of the main things that they said that can actually assist you being organized is basically planning ahead. Mm-hmm. That's one of those things. Because in planning ahead, it keeps you balanced. Yeah. It keeps you from being stressed out. I use a list, too. Like, I try to do a to-do list, a daily one, though.
Yes. Like, I have one in my planner.
And try to knock the things out in the day.
And it feel good.
Because if it... Exactly.
Especially when you're crossing
you
crossing
feel so accomplished. Oh! Exactly.
Ain't nothing like scratching something off my lip.
Exactly.
Oh, y'all. I find that brings me peace.
Yeah,
like, I
bet
so. I know it's an OCD thing.
No,
like, I
bet so.
I need to look at my calendar.
Because I can only imagine when you walk to your calendar and you see that you only got one thing left to do. It's like, oh.
Yeah.
Well, when can I add some fun in here? That's another thing.
Like,
but that's the thing. You plan your fun.
Yeah.
It's
and
hard
don't
when
let
you
people
kids,
discourage
though.
You.
That
because a lot of people be like, you can't, you don't plan this. You it's supposed to be organic, but sometimes your life doesn't permit or that
to
however being organic like that.
Yeah.
So you have to plan. Like me and my boyfriend, like we plan dates.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
yes,
date night.
You have to.
I'm pretty sure a lot of couples do that.
Yeah.
Or like with him, he has a very busy work schedule. So he'll plan his work schedule.
He better be booked and busy
to make sure that we can spend time together in the daytime. Because if he don't plan it, bitch, it ain't gonna
happen. I'll see him all.
Exactly. Well, I mean, I'm gonna see him, but I'm not gonna see him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what I mean.
So
yeah.
You have to plan, like,
I mean,
plan
we
your
did it
free
this
time.
Week with one of Maya, one of our homegirls.
Yeah.
She set up a Google
that
calendar
so
invite
cute.
For us to get drinks, and I was laughing at it because it's just like. We old that
we're
doing
grown
it.
Up.
But we have to because like Lauren said, I have a very demanding schedule. We all work like we have to. It's important to fit in, you know, that leisure time
exactly.
with your girls. Because if not, we would be like, well, we ain't got nothing to do. We go
exactly.
to sleep or do it. You know?
And sleep wins for me every time.
Every time.
I got some extras. I'm about to take a 20-minute nap.
Every
all right,
time.
Y'all good?
Right.
Okay.
And you don't notice the need to plan it until you start realizing that you haven't been doing it.
Exactly.
And it's then like, you're like, bitch,
I
gotta
talk
do
to y'all in a minute.
Like, what's a way for me to do this?
Yeah.
Like, oh, shit. What's
I do
way
that,
for me
y'all.
To,
you know? Can you believe I do that in my marriage.
Girl, what? I feel like listen, that's the best time.
Y'all, no, listen. Like, me and Derek see each other every day. We're literally, like, bouncing off each other. Mm-hmm. Drop-offs, pick-ups. Mm-hmm. You got this. Okay, I got that.
Yeah.
But we're never, like, here.
Yeah.
And I realize, I'm like, I haven't loved on you.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'll be like, kids, close the door.
It's look, time for some loving. I just watched not Kevin Hart today. We watching TV loving. Today. Yeah. And don't come back until we done watching TV.
I mean, not all that, you know, of course that, but I mean, like, just let me hug
Let's
you.
Just
let me
talk.
Embrace me, hold you type thing. Like, I notice, I'm like, men need that. Because I notice he act a certain way when I'm not giving him love. Because I get the same way, and I be like, first of all, you ain't said I love
look,
you
today. Let me tell you something. Mine, we have this little board on our refrigerator, and this may be like some advice or a little suggestion for y'all. He writes, he put hug, compliment, and I love you, something like that, and that reminds him.
Yeah,
he needs to give me a hug.
Yeah,
he needs to give me a compliment, and he needs to say I love you every single day.
I got that. I got the sticky notes up like
hard.
That too. Yeah,
yeah, it is hard, and you have to do what's best for you. Yeah. You can't do it how everybody else do it. Like exactly. I realize, like mine's is not somebody's just gonna automatically remember.
Yeah,
he's
yeah.
just not like that.
And he's busy,
so it's okay. Some people got the luxury where men they gonna remember. They gonna come with the flowers. They don't need no reminders. Yeah. Some people just can't.
That's
do it was good for
but
you.
The fact right, that he's Lord, actively telling himself that I need to do that for you that's speaks so volumes because it's just
and
like I know
shit too.
Right
yeah.
I know I could get consumed with my day
with my work
so I want
like,
you to know that you are valued
yes it's
that's
important
beautiful. You gotta know this because I do we have in our room like in our desk nook there's sticky notes it says
come on desk
now.
Nook
I know as soon as I said it I heard how I sounded it says it's two sets of sticky notes one says to do now to do later
yeah
and I always write something on there
yeah
it says like to do now love me and it says to do later love me more
oh that's right
come on I love these
so
girl
that's right
I must make some sticky notes on my wall. This is so cute.
I'm gonna be in Mary Jane. Got sticky notes everywhere,
girl. That brings me to one of the what is it called? Yeah, I'm losing. I be losing my words. My bad, y'all. One of the ways, seven ways to stay balanced.
Okay.
One of the ways to stay balanced. It says to keep an eye on your emotions. So that's a bomb segue to what you were saying. Like love me and love me more. Like that has a lot to do with your emotions. Do y'all believe that? Like. How you perceive things from people or what triggers your emotions has a lot to do with how you feel about yourself.
Absolutely. I feel like that's where most of your emotions come from is that from others, you know, and we talk about validation for a lot, but we're human. Exactly.
So if you have yourself in check, then
whatever
reason and likeliness that other people will affect you as much.
Exactly.
Like that clicked for me when I read that. I was like, damn.
Yeah.
Like,
cause when you in a good mood, it's just like there's nothing that
there's
you
really
can
nothing.
Do that takes me off this high right
exactly.
now. And you'll notice like you in a bad mood.
Yeah.
So you go over there.
Mm-hmm. We do it all the time. Check your energy.
Exactly.
And let me know what you do.
So we can low key relate it. Like you know how sometimes you be feeling funky and you be like, why do I have an attitude? Like why am I irritated? Why do I blah 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 blah? We could look around and be like, bitch, am I organized? Is my shit
right?
Are them clothes folded?
Yeah. And a lot of that too is like mental. It's just like, what are you mentally thinking about that you can make that probably not even a it's probably not even a priority.
Exactly.
And you can put that in the back of your head and mentally be like, oh, I'm good.
Yeah,
I'm good.
Exactly. I saw. I'm reading. You know, I'm reading How to Be a Badass by Jen Cicero.
Yeah,
come on.
And she said, take the other person out of the situation. I don't know if I've said that before, but she said basically take the other person out of the situation and reevaluate what's going on.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And that's another way to check yourself and check
because nine
emotions.
Times out of ten it's all personal. I mean,
or,
it's all you.
Or you can only control yourself.
Period.
So I can either it is me or it's them. So I can only control myself at the end of the day. So if you realize that it's not you, that's a relief. And if it is you, then you know you need to check yourself.
Yeah.
So I actually started doing that and it's definitely made a really big effect.
I've started doing something like that too. Cause I'm learning cause I've been taking up, I've actually had two ethics classes back to back. So my mind is just like super open. Yeah. So it's just like where I am now, I'm in the spirit and in a posture of participation. Like, I respect everyone's journey. Like, you know, if that's what you want to do, that's fine. But I'm just not going to participate in it. Right. I'm not going to participate in this part. How about that?
Yeah.
Like, maybe later, but I'm not. Like, I have to really check myself because I am a receiver energy. And I do act on my emotions sometimes. Mm. And I will project my emotions or my views onto you and get upset when you're not performing the way I would do. Want you
that's
to.
Real.
I'm like, that's not fair to you.
Right. That's real.
I'm giving you these expectations that I have for
myself. That's
that
real.
That ain't your expectation.
Exactly. Yeah.
And when you grasp that and it's like, you know what? You're entitled to do whatever you want.
Right.
Do.
And I can pick and choose if I want
to. And I'm not going to. These are my emotions. I control them. So I'm not going to get mad because that's what you want to do. If you cared, then if you cared about how I felt, you would move differently. But if you don't move on my behalf.
Yeah. Move on yours.
Do what you want to do. I mean, sometimes it comes at my expense and that was just your choice.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But
you can pick and choose to be mad at them or not. You can take it as just like, you know what?
Because it's just some stuff, I'm just like.
Exactly. Nowadays, and it's just
not, don't take it personal.
Exactly. Nowadays, when I see people, when I see things happening, I be like, oh my gosh, that's so sad. Like, poor them. Like, that's so unfortunate for them. I don't really take it on as much as I used to and be
it
like,
feels
that's
good
crazy.
To do that, right? Yeah.
It's just like, dang, that's so unfortunate for them. Like, I pray for them and I hope they,
that's real.
You know, because that's what they want to do. Like, I don't know why we grew to have this attachment to controlling other people's lives.
We talked about that.
I cannot control judging people. That's control.
Yeah,
that's trying to control somebody.
I'm gonna put my views on you. You're not me.
You're not me. And you should be okay with the way with the way I live my life because it's obviously making me happy.
Right.
That's what you should be focused on. Like if you're a friend, a family member, whatever. You should be focused on your family member, your friend's happiness.
Yes.
And if what they're doing is making them happy, then
doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm. Now, if they're harming themselves, it's a different story.
And I say, as long as you feel good with your soul at night, by all means,
do what you gotta do.
It's really you don't know how much time you have.
Exactly. Yeah.
So don't live based on someone else's standard.
Exactly.
Like that's crazy to me.
Right. Okay. So next one says, don't take on more than you can handle.
Period. Seriously.
Ways to be balanced and organized. Don't take on more than you can handle. That is like it's something that people battle with so much. I see it in some of my family members.
Yeah.
Even my boyfriend himself, do not take on more than you can handle.
I
even myself too,
I'm telling people no, so I can get like overwhelmed.
I'll be like, I don't care. Put the whole team on my back.
Especially at work, I'll just be like, I'll do it.
Right.
I'll do it.
And then next thing I know, I'm like,
then you get overwhelmed, and now I'm anxious because it's just like, okay, I need some help. Mm-hmm. I ain't gonna get this done. Mm-hmm. So yeah.
And what happens? You get upset and you start projecting your feelings, and you start getting
attacking people.
Because you're taking on. Why do y'all think that people take on more than they can handle? Like when you know damn well you don't want to do it. Why say yes?
I feel like maybe it's a pride thing.
Definitely a pride thing.
Yeah.
What do you mean like a pride? Like so if you say no, then what? You feel like
you can't handle it.
Well, that and then sometimes, right? And then sometimes I just know I could do stuff better.
Right? That's
the thing. But I can get it done, you know. I can rely on myself to get it done than relying on someone else to get it done.
Yeah.
So I just rather just do it myself like that.
Because you know the whole saying, you know, if you want something done right, you do it yourself.
Right.
And I just be like, I have a hard time.
It could be an ego thing, you know, ego pride.
It's not an ego thing to me. I like things done the way I like them done.
Right.
So if it has to do with me, just let me do it.
But what if it causes you stress though?
I lost my mind.
It does.
So if you had to, let me ask you this. So if y'all had to choose say y'all planned a spa day on the same day as, I don't know, some damn shit you picked up randomly that you could possibly not do and they would still be okay. But you said that, I'm going to go ahead and do it.
Oh, well, me
but
now,
you didn't
I'd
realize
like,
that you had the spot. So would y'all choose to go and take care of yourself, do your self-care, because this is once a month that you have this spa day. Like, you can't get this any other time. Or go help your sister-in-law, cousin, friend who asked you if you could just come and help them put up balloons around the church conference.
My sister-in-law, cousin, friend. But honestly, I would probably move the spa day because I'd be like,
me too. If I was in our, and it's so funny. Somebody just told me this the other day. Like, all of this is coming full circle.
Yeah.
Because it's just like, I'm making like major moves right now in my life.
You better make them move.
And not the, like, not the small ones, the major, major ones.
Okay. And
major.
I've been so like stressed about it. It's been an emotional like roller coaster in a good way, but it's just so stressful. And someone told me was just like, Chloe, if you was doing this for somebody else, you would do it in a heartbeat. Mm. But the fact that you're doing it for you, you hesitate and stress. And I'm like, God damn. And he was just like, write on your phone, like, I'm doing this for Chloe. And constantly remind yourself that. And I'm like,
that's beautiful.
That is.
You're not about to read me. But stop it.
Did you put it on your phone?
Real. I'm going to do it. Because, you know, I'm always putting a little close on my phone. But it's real, though. Because it's just, and like Sonara, I would probably move the spy date to go help somebody else. Because I'm so used to being there for others versus myself. And yeah, I know that's something that I desperately want to work on because it's just, I have to. Because
people will still love you even if you don't. Because they won't. Who cares? And then that goes to what I saw a post on Instagram Felicia Rashad was saying. She was just like,
She got an Insta?
No.
I was about to say, why am I not following this queen?
I don't know, but this is a video of an interview she did. Okay. And she was just saying, why do I care about what people think about me? As long as I know about what I think about myself.
Yeah.
As long as I know in my core of who I am, what other people project onto me or what their perception of me is does not matter.
Yeah.
So even if, because I'm the same way, y'all, I feel bad. And even if I did say, oh, no, girl, I can't come, I'd be at the spa feeling horrible.
Can't even enjoy my time.
Exactly. I would not be relaxed.
So let me just
because I would be having anxiety. Oh, they talking about me. Oh, she gonna think I'm a horrible person. Da, da, da. But y'all, like, if we don't take care of ourselves, we won't be good for nobody. Yeah. We won't be able to go to the sister-in-law, friend, baby, cousin, whatever.
I can definitely personally attest to that because that was me.
Exactly.
I was no good for nobody. Like, it was ugly. Like, no one wanted to be around me.
Yeah.
And I was just lonely. I'm like, what is wrong?
Or no, you doing it me. And you got like an attitude or whatever.
Yes.
Which
defeats the purpose. I not do it at
all.
Exactly. It's real. Take care of yourself.
Exactly. So don't take on more than you can handle. Okay. Mm-hmm. Learn your human limitations.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you're not a superhuman. You cannot fit more hours into the day. And if you're following all the tips, well, obviously. It says you're flawed, fantastic human being. So going around like a thing possessed, trying to get everything done in the span of a few hours is not only unrealistic, it also suggests that you need to sit down and reconsider what's important in your life. Staying balanced and staying happy are not impossible when you happen to be living a busy life. It just basically says, like, just do these tips, like, basically, like,
no, those are
try
good.
Just
this,
try
this actually, you know? Makes me want to go home tonight and write in my journal, like, the things that I have to do this week versus the things, like, I like to do and I want to do this week.
Ooh, and making and sure trying to fuse them
the and make sure I do them all.
Yeah,
you know? Like,
so seriously. how do you make sure, because you said you're a very disciplined person, so how do you make sure that you do the things that you have to do every week? Because I'm pretty sure they get done every week.
Yeah, like,
how do you do that with your schedule? Because what's your schedule, Chloe? Just so that everybody knows. I mean, not on no creepy shit, but.
No, I have two jobs. So it's easy to say I work every day.
Yeah.
But but for my main job, I work on the weekends and I'm off that Thursday and Friday. So I have and then I work nights. So besides the weekends when I work.
She's booked.
Very, very just up and down schedule. So it is hard to like balance like, you know, social life plus sleep, which I value so much, plus time with my family and everything. I just, mentally, I try to make sure that I know the hours of the day on what needs to be accomplished before I need to go accomplish stuff. Like, even when I'm at work and I need to do outside stuff, I know that work is busy between these hours. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna do work. And then at this hour, I need to get this done before I can pick up anything else. And it works for me because, like I say, I'll lose stuff if I write it down on paper or even my phone. You always tell me I need to update my phone. I don't use this for nothing. It stay on Do Not Disturb.
Ooh.
So my phone is the last thing that I'd be worried about. But it just, you know, just discipline and just sacrificing. You know, like sometimes I may have to sacrifice that hour or two of sleep because I want to hang with my girls.
Yeah.
I know I ain't caught up with them in about a month. And I know if I don't do it, if we don't do it today, it's going to be another month.
Exactly.
So I may need to sacrifice. You know what? I could take a 2 hour nap, but I ain't seen my girls in a minute. I'll be all right. I'll sleep afterwards.
Yeah.
So it's,
So dang, imbalance, you sometimes may have to sacrifice.
I think so. I personally think so. Or what you thought. Writing stuff down, like what you thought would get done on Monday,
you gonna have to bring it down to Tuesday. I definitely do that. I go back to the to-do list, and then whatever I didn't, it rolls over to the next,
because this is life, period. Shit come up. I can sit here and realistically think that I can accomplish all these goals that I set for today, but some shit may happen, and it's just like, oh no, let me roll it down. But it's always making sure that you are aware that I move this to the next day, I need to get this accomplished, or I'm gonna just be behind.
And that just goes right back to the fact that being balanced and being organized, it's all a process. It's not really a destination. It's something that you're constantly trying to grow and get better. Yeah. It's like a muscle. You're trying to grow and get better every single day. And that's the beauty of it, really.
Right.
I've learned to love the beauty in the journey.
Embrace it.
And embrace it.
Because I feel like every time you think, you know, I feel like life always throws, like, tests at you, and every time you think you've like passed one test, life throw another. So like you say, we're never at an end goal with the things that we need to accomplish. Like, we're always going to be accomplishing something. So it's one, not even being so hard on yourself, because I think I do that a lot too, like, oh my god, I didn't do this, and I need to do this, and I need to do this. And sometimes it's just like, be still.
Exactly.
Be still.
It's gonna get done. Maybe not in the time that you thought it's gonna get done, but it's gonna get done.
Exactly.
Lose control.
Exactly. Yeah.
You gotta lose control.
Accomplishments and failures are all a part of balance. Think about it that way too. It balances each other out.
Yeah.
Because you're not gonna always win.
You're not. And so what's winning without losing a couple of times? You never know the joys of winning.
Exactly. You got to be comfortable with taking L's. That's what I learned.
Exactly.
Like what I was dealing with this week, because I've been on the winning train. Like, I'm winning. I want to win at everything I do. So for me to have a setback of such where I'm like kind of like L. I'm like,
Lesson.
Because my dub got to come soon.
It's going to come.
It's like at the studies table.
I'm taking my win going to be big.
Exactly.
It's fine. Yeah. I'm alive. My kids are fed. Everybody's smiling. It's okay.
Exactly.
Like, that's my thing, is giving up control.
Yeah.
And like you said, like you have to practice, after practice, being still.
Yeah.
I know I do.
Ooh, let me figure out how I can make it work. I can make it work. Give it to me, I'll make it work. But now I'm just like, no, we just gonna let the chips fall as they may.
Seriously. I'm a very controlling person with self and others. Like,
that's how I'm at work. I'm like, don't touch it. Don't touch it. I'll give it
and
to
being
me.
Still is a hard task for me. Like, what you mean? I could be doing this. I could fix this. I could
so
fix
many
that.
To
what
do.
You mean sit still? But it is something that I definitely want to practice, because I am always looking for, like, peace.
Yeah.
And I know, like we talked about earlier, peace is temporary. Like, you may have it for a second and may lose, but I'm always trying to get more of it than what I do now. Like, that's the goal of life, is just being okay with being okay.
Being okay with not being okay too.
Exactly. Yeah.
Because some days I'm like, I'm not okay. Like, I can't be the positive friend. Like, I can't do
but
it
I'm
today.
I'm
grateful for the few
small
things.
Yes. Yeah.
I have life in my body, because there are some that do not.
Yeah.
My kids are happy.
Start
they
there.
Don't know what's going on.
Seriously.
I start from the basics.
Exactly.
Like,
when I pray, I always start with, God, thank you for food in my belly, a roof over my head, a car for me to get to work, the job. You know, like, I try to thank him for the little things, because I think we, as people, forget to, like, praise him for
the small
stuff. We forget, like, you ate today?
Yeah.
You got clothes?
Girl, I started with, thank you for letting me open my eyes this morning. When my alarm go off at 5 o'clock, I open my eyes. I'm like, thank you, God.
Exactly. Yeah. We're always trying. We're always thinking about more, which is a good thing.
Yeah.
But it's also causes us not to be appreciative of
the
small things.
The balance.
So that's waking up, when you wake up in the morning and just thinking about all the things you're grateful for. That's like a perfect way.
I get overwhelmed. I literally, when I go and count my blessings,
girl,
like this,
it makes you want to shout.
Thinking about it right now, I almost shout it, because I'm like,
exactly.
Thank you. Because I'm going through my prayer that I do every morning. I'm like, thank you. I touched my husband, went in, he in the bed. I'm like, okay. He's breathing. Out. When I go and wake my kids up, I'm like, okay. I walk in my living room. I'm like, okay, everything's still here.
Amen.
I in the robber's last room.
Feel me? Because they kicked the doors in at where I stay. I'm trying to get up out of
there. Move out of that dorm room of an apartment complex.
Do you hear me? It's in the works. I go in my kids' room. I'm like, thank God, because I have anxiety with my kids on the other side of the house. I'm like, they're fine. They're covered. This place is covered. And and with that being said, I need advice on sage because I need some.
Girl,
I
got some energy. Sage mint on Thursday.
That's right. That's right.
I need some for my house because it's the energy in there.
What are you doing after? What are you doing after the show? Okay, you want to follow me? Because I got it up the street.
Really?
That's where I'm going.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You want to go get some?
Yeah.
Where at? Oh, I'll go.
That's part of my organization.
Five and Below. Five and Below has sage.
Okay.
Really?
Yes.
Oh,
that's where I got it from. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm out to buy. Do I got time? I think I can.
I'm like, oh, I'm looking at the time. I'm like,
stop at the stove too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My little stove. Sunday, you know.
The stove. But I do like organization. I got to get.
It is. So basically, at the end of the day, y'all, if you are not balanced, if you're not organized, you can strive for it because it is a journey.
Mm-hmm.
So even if you haven't even been organized or even thought to be balanced in the past, like, you can just get on the bandwagon now and
try it. Nothing. Just try it.
And just start. Like,
start with a list.
It will help. It will definitely help you reduce the feeling of being overwhelmed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You will achieve more in less time.
Yes.
Gain a sense of self-control if you're out here not feeling like you got control of shit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Reduce your stress level. You will gain energy and calm from your space. Make better use of your talents and your skills.
Yeah.
That speaks to me for sure.
100%. Have you ever, you're not organized. You're not performing.
You're not going to feel creative. You're not going to feel like you perform. You're going to feel clogged and like feel like
cluttered.
You don't really.
Yeah.
And
chaos will box you in.
Hmm.
It'll box you in.
And it will help you to spend more time on what's important to you.
Yeah.
And you know what's important to you most of the time is what's going to make you happy.
Yeah.
And happiness, we know happy people stay alive for a long time. So.
Period.
Hey, dude.
Period.
That was
period.
A good episode. I took a lot from that.
Come on.
Me too.
I took a lot from that.
Let's go make a list.
Yes.
I'm making a physical and a mental one.
Yes.
I need a new journal because I'm looking at your book right there.
It's so cute, isn't it?
Thank you. I got it from, I think, TJ Maxx.
Okay. TJ Maxx has the best journals.
Oh, no.
Them
or Marshall's.
I was about to say, Ross is mine. They Ross and Target are mine, girl.
Yes.
Y'all get organized.
So, and this is the perfect day because it's Sunday.
It's Sunday. Yes.
And this get Sunday energy.
Well, when they hear it,
it'll it's going to be Wednesday. But today
but,
is Sunday.
And then the thing about it, Wednesday is the 1st of May.
Oh.
So hello.
So hello.
Alignment.
Hello, man.
Yes.
Way to start it.
We're going
to
start it off with a new month.
Yeah. So this is the first day of May, so
hello.
You can go ahead and start your month balanced, organized, try to get yourself together.
Yes.
If that means spring cleaning, go in and take your winter clothes and put your spring clothes out, clean out that closet you keep ignoring. Like, do what you
set
have to
do. Set a monthly budget.
Exactly. Well,
that's exactly what I'm going home to do.
Yes.
Getting my budget together. Yeah.
It only gets better from here.
Yeah.
You have to. You can make your life what
babe.
You want it to.
You sure
make
can.
It. Your life is what you make it, okay?
Okay. Start with being organized and balanced.
There you
organized
go.
Organize and find your center, find your balance.
Okay.
Yes.
Drink your water and mind
drink
your business.
Drink your water.
Hey.
And
hear
mind
me?
Your business.
And mind your goddamn business.
That's another way to
mind
stay balanced.
Mind your business.
I can't. Thank you, babes, for
thank
listening.
As always, make sure you guys are following us on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook. Make sure you
and
go
tell
like
a friend
our page.
And tell a friend and tell a friend.
Exactly. Stay in our DMs. Stay in our emails. We will be coming out with those new designs for the show.
Yes, we are. We promise. We are, again, getting organized.
Getting
in lieu of.
Okay.
In lieu of getting organized.
Yeah.
In lieu. Okay.
We're definitely getting those shirts out.
Love it.
Thanks for everybody for the requests, the follows, y'all.
I know.
We on a move.
We
it's
are.
Okay to, you know, we stepping back. We see.
Mm-hmm.
We getting a little
stand fast.
Stand fast.
Mm.
You better hold.
Oh, and side note, if you are interested in being a sponsor
that's
of Brown Sugar Babe, email us at brownsugarbabepod@gmail.com. We are looking for sponsors and we'll let you know,
the logistics of it.
Of it when you
send
email
your
us. So like I said, email us. BrownSugarBabePod@gmail.com or you can always DM us, which y'all do a lot.
Yeah.
BrownSugarBabePod.
Appreciate that.
It's a perfect way to get your business marketed.
Yes.
To,
don't jump on the bandwagon when we hot and popping and millions and thousands.
And you wasn't with us shooting in the gym.
Come on.
And y'all know we love to support black businesses and small businesses and everything. So
we love local businesses as well, doing it for the mo, you know.
Exactly.
Hit us up.
Yes. We love y'all. We hope you have a good week.
Have a great organized. Nice week.
Thank you.
Great, organized and balanced.
Prosperous.
Yes.
Balance.
Bye.